In the current highly dynamic world of retail, the players have an unprecedented opportunity to leverage new advanced technologies and seamless cross-channel shopping, intelligent supply chain, and personalized expert service to deliver exceptional customer experience. While technological innovations certainly play a role in the competition, it is getting clear that the human factor becomes the key to sustainable innovation. What brings a lasting competitive advantage is novel human resources and team management approaches. Only the companies that master the art of human innovations will succeed in the long run.
My name is Kolja Sauerberg. I'm head of ERP, product data and dropshipment. METRO Markets is a part of the METRO group, and METRO is one of the leading wholesalers. It's mainly operating in over 20 countries in Asia and in Europe. And METRO is selling food and non-food items to professional customers. We would like to create a leading and innovative B2B marketplace. We try to solve business challenges with technology so that we can optimize and scale. METRO Markets is a very young company. I think when we started, we only had 9 months, and then we had our ambitious goal to go live, which we also made happen in Germany. This was our first market entry. In March 2021, we also had our first international rollout to Spain. So I think these were the biggest milestones which we so far achieved. And I think there's a lot of things to happen in the future. This was a very challenging situation because when we said, okay, we want to go live in 9 months, I had the challenge that on the one hand side, I needed to ramp up a team. And on the other hand, I also needed to deliver some solution to make the go live happen. One key reason why I think why I went also with DataArt, I think we also had a tender phase at the beginning, of course. And I think these mindsets, the sharing of the same values, and also the understanding of the challenges which we have, the pragmatic solutions which we needed in these ambitious times. If you are in such a situation, you are looking for a partner, not for, let's say, an extended workbench. So I was really looking for a partner who can take ownership, who can help me to master this challenge, to make it happen. So I was looking for a partner who has a lot of technology skills in the company and who could also bring a lot of people with the right values, with the right mindset, to our teams, because in the end, if you run these kind of complicated and complex IT projects, it's all about people, and people are the key success factor. Before we decided also to go with DataArt, I had a few interviews actually with team members, and I think this gives usually a quite good impression about the company and, you know, besides all the marketing activities, what is really behind it. And after the interviews, I was really impressed about how driven actually the people were, so how much ownership they had, how much passion. And I think that was exactly needed also to make that happen. Not only the first go live, but also afterwards to build a great product. For that, it's important to understand what we have built. So I think we have built up multiple agile and cross-functional teams. And each team consisted of multiple roles, like a product manager, a tech lead, engineers, QA, designers, agile coaches, Scrum Master, you name it. I think most of the teams are using Scrum. So every 2 weeks they meet, have new playing sessions and so on. But not every team used the same. So also we had Kanban and so on. I think it's up to the team, to be honest, in the end. Yeah. But we supported all these kind of methodologies and frameworks also with Scrum Masters and Agile coaches, also from DataArt. Yeah. Across team, you need to have a good alignment. And of course here, you don't need a Scrum framework or something else, but you need people who are open-minded and also are able to exchange and have an end-to-end understanding. I think that's more important. I think we did it really in an agile way. We discovered a lot of new things which we did not have on our agenda. I think that was also super important, not only for the people but also for our companies, METRO Markets and DataArt, to be a little bit flexible because we constantly discovered new things which we needed to consider. But I think that's also then most of the fun. So in the end, you always need to adapt. And then if you make it happen after 9 months, it's a really great feeling. And I think from my perspective, we always took it as a partnership. So I think for me, it's important to be on eye level. So to also empower a lot of people in the team. Yeah. And I think that was also one of my major principles when I tried to integrate DataArt together with METRO Markets, because also we had an internal hiring process, of course, and internal teams. In the end, we had mixed teams, but I didn't want to have the boundaries between DataArt and METRO Markets. And I think the biggest compliment we usually got from my colleagues from METRO Markets when they mixed up if somebody was working for DataArt for METRO Markets, I think this was also not clear. And I think that is super important, because in the end, what is behind it is that you treat everybody the same, and it doesn't matter if the person comes from METRO Markets or DataArt. And then you see also fantastic developments of different team members. I'm very proud on both sides what I've seen in the past 2.5 years. And I think that is also a very positive energy besides all the milestones which we reached, if you see people grow in this direction.